rebellion, may it be revolts, uprisings, or mere rallies, and how it affected and still affects our country.
The Philippines is socially and geographically fragmented. Its terrain is nearly all mountainous, and it is made up of 7,100 islands, within which live more than 100 tribal groups who speak 70 different languages. These factors and the history of peasant revolts are important in understanding the problem of rebellions, insurgencies, and revolts which has faced many Filipino governments at present. The Philippines has been plagued by rebellions and insurgencies throughout the history. Defined as an organized movement aimed at the overthrow of a constituted government through the use of subversion and armed conflict, insurgency is said to be a form of modern warfare. Differences in ideology and faith, problems of underdevelopment and poverty, and social dissatisfaction are some of the main issues that have given rise to insurrections in the country since the colonial period. During the Spanish colonial period in the Philippines, there were several revolts against the Spanish colonial government by indigenous Moro, Lumad, Indians, Chinese, and Insulares, often with the goal of re-establishing the rights and powers that had traditionally belonged to Lumad, Timawa, Maginoo Raja, Moro Datus, Chinese settler traders, and even foreign Criollo settlers. During the American colonization, there had also been rebellions such as the Moro Rebellion and Negritos Revolution, and the goal is the same, the re-establishment of rights and powers of the Filipinos. During the Japanese invasion, the Filipinos continued to fight in this form. Then came the Hukbalahap, an anti-Japanese guerrilla movement formed by the peasant farmers of central Luzon. Indeed, rebellions today mirror the rebellions in the past. These rebellions have been the weapons of the Filipinos in fighting for their rights and freedom since the colonization period.
In the Philippines, rebellion had been on the rise since time immemorial. Filipinos had rebelled against the Spaniards, the Americans, and the Japanese colonizers. But their fight does not end there, even though we are now free and democratic.
A rebellion, uprising, or insurrection is a refusal of obedience or order. It may therefore be seen as encompassing a range of behaviors aimed at destroying or taking over the position of an established authority, such as government, governor, president, political leader, financial institution, or even person in charge. On the one hand, the forms of behavior can include nonviolent methods, such as the phenomena of civil disobedience, civil resistance, and nonviolent resistance. On the other hand, it may encompass violent campaigns. Those who participate in rebellions, especially if they are armed rebellions, are known as rebels. The Zamboanga City crisis erupted on September 9, 2013, when this MNLF faction attempted to raise the flag of the self-proclaimed Bangsamoro Republic at Zamboanga City Hall, which had earlier declared its independence on August 12, 2013, in Talipao, Cebu. This armed incursion was met by the Armed Forces of the Philippines, or AFP, and the Philippine National Police, or PNP, which sought to free the hostages and expel the MNLF from the city. The standoff degenerated into an urban warfare and had brought parts of the city under a standstill for days. On September 28, the government declared the end of military operations in Zamboanga City after successfully defeating the MNLF. On January 24, 2014, the Philippine government chief negotiator Miriam Coronel Ferrer and MILF chief negotiator Muhagir Iqbal signed a peace agreement in Kuala Lumpur. The agreement would pave the way for the creation of the new Muslim autonomous entity called Bangsamoro, under a law to be approved by the Philippine Congress. The government aims to set up the region by 2016. The New People's Army, or NPA, on the other hand, also called the Bagong Hukbong Bayan, is the armed wing of the Communist Party of the Philippines, having 6,000 to 10,000 strong members, as estimated by United States CIA. It was formed and founded by Bernabe Buscaino, aka Commander Dante, on March 29, 1969. The Maoist NPA conducts its armed guerrilla struggle based on the strategical line of protected people's war. The NPA collects revolutionary taxes in areas where it operates mostly from businesses. These include mining and logging operations, especially foreign-owned enterprises that provide employment to the people, with the belief that crippling the country's economy would give favor for a revolution to occur. This group was designated as a foreign terrorist organization by the United States in August 2002 and by the European Union in November 2005. The NPA's founder, Bernabe Buscaino, lives in the Philippines in peace but under close watch by the government. The NPA operates mostly in rural areas, and their targets often include military, police, government informers, and rural residents who refuse to pay revolutionary taxes.
In the Philippines, rallies are just the norm.
A rally, a demonstration, or street protest is action by a mass group or collection of groups of people in favor of a political or other cause. It normally consists of walking in a mass march, formation, and either beginning with or meeting at a designated endpoint or rally to hear speakers. Rallies, though not as grave as rebellion, can also be considered as a mild rebellion to the government.
One of the biggest rallies to date on the Philippines is the Million People March, held last year.
The so-called Million People March was the first of an ongoing series of protests in the Philippines calling for the total abolition of the Pork Barrel Fund, triggered by public anger over the Priority Development Assistance Fund scam. Initial calls circulated through social media, mainly on Facebook and Twitter, to convene a protest on August 26, 2013 at Luneta Park in Manila, as well as other cities nationwide and overseas. Some media commentators consider this as the first ever massive rally in the Philippines, called and organized mostly through social media channels.
Effort in halting the uprisings and rebellions in our country, primarily through armed forces and law.
1990, Republic Act No. 6968, an act punishing the crime of coup d'etat, was constitutionalized under the 8th Congress of the Philippines. Section 4, Article 135 of the Revised Penal Code is hereby amended to read as follows. Article 135, penalty for rebellion, insurrection, or coup d'etat. Any person who promotes, maintains, or heads a rebellion or insurrection shall suffer the penalty of reclusion perpetua. However, although the punishment for rebellion and coup d'etat is reclusion perpetua or permanent imprisonment of 40 years, many rebels still continue to uprise.
The country has faced countless rebellions in history, and it is still facing the same dilemma until today. There are several effects of rebellion in our country, and it is growing out of hand. Rebellions are a threat to peace and order in the country, and have been a danger to the security of many provinces and even cities. Rebellions also mirror the divided and disunited people of our country brought about by the colonization. Lastly, rebellions depict the rotting system of the government and how the people struggle, may it be in peace or violence, to be heard.